Hi, I'm Brent Colley. I'm the president of the Sharon Historical Society and Museum, and this is Jody Smith. She's also on our board of trustees. And what we're here for today is a public gathering to celebrate Ed Kirby's Lifetime Achievement Award. The Lifetime Achievement Award pretty much is custom made for Mr. Kirby, as the idea behind it, it's the highest award we can give as a board of trustees to an individual in our community. So the idea was to honor someone who has given back not only to our society but also to the community. Ed has been an educator. Ed has been a leader. Ed has taken this society to new levels. But not only here, the community as a whole benefits from everything that he's done over the course of his lifetime. And today we're here just to celebrate that, to gather people here that normally wouldn't come together, and just to really showcase everything that is good about an individual in the community.
And to really celebrate Ed and his lovely wife Mary, mm-hmm. and they continue to be an inspiration to the community and to people in and around Sharon, and they're wonderful family, and we're so thrilled to
have him be
a part of the Historical Society here.
Their
where
whole
he was president
family
for
was
years.
A part of the events last night too, which is great. He had all five kids here, some of the grandkids,
his grandkids.
It was a pretty amazing time.
It was a great time
last night. So, thank you for coming here today to talk to us, and you'll see more of the presentations in just a few moments. Okay, thank you all for coming here today. If the people in the back could move up to the front here. Thank you. Okay, today is a special day and celebration here with the community of our first annual Lifetime Achievement Award. Edward M. Kirby is our recipient. And last night we celebrated with a great number of people over at the Sharon Country Club. And it was just an amazing evening with a lot of memories, a lot of friends and families, and it was greatly enjoyed. So thank you all for coming here today to celebrate as a community, because that's really what the theme of this award is. The Edward M. Kirby Lifetime Achievement Award is the highest honor given at the discretion of the board of the Historical Society and Museum. It recognizes a lifetime of achievement by a person who has demonstrated through his or her actions the diverse ways that citizens apply their skills for the betterment of the community as a whole, forging meaningful links between our past, our present, and our future for the good of all. So it could not have gone to a better person. So thank you, Ed, and please let us all celebrate. For me, Ed has become such a special part of my life. He came into my life just when I needed him most, and since then he's become a friend and a mentor and truly an inspiration. And what we spoke a bit about last night is what was great is that as we got to know each other better, our works kind of came together. I do a lot of stuff with Mark Twain and his life, and I was doing a project where I was trying to connect as many towns and cities to Mark Twain's life as I could here in Connecticut. So I thought, well, maybe we have something in Sharon, and I thought maybe there would be something connected with Hotchkiss, for instance, but as it turns out, Ed was doing a project with Frank J. Sprague. That's where Mo lives now, in the Frank J. Sprague house. And Sprague and Twain were great friends. Sprague was an inventor, and for whatever reason, Mark Twain was really drawn to inventors. So Sprague was involved in electronic traction control, like trains and elevators, all these amazing things. And the connection here in Sharon to Twain, who died in my hometown of Reading, was that they were great friends, and Sprague came down for Mark Twain. Clara Clemens was Mark Twain's daughter, and he was there for the wedding. And for whatever reason, it was kind of a shotgun wedding. It was planned like 2 weeks prior to it occurred. And no one had a camera. But Frank J. Sprague had a camera in his car, so he took the only wedding photos that day. So that was a special connection. So it was good that we got to work together that way. And obviously, since then, you've been an important part of my life. So thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Liz, would you like to say some words?
Yeah, I'll say a word or two. Get out of my way. The board president, really? No. We're so happy that everybody is here tonight. And I just want to correct, Brent, we're having trouble because this is the first time we've ever given this award. It is not an annual award. This is an award that will be given as the Board of Trustees sees fit. So this is a very special award for that reason. And I read last night like a 27-page speech. Sit down, everyone. But I'm not going to do that today. But I want to make sure that I get it right, and I don't say anything that will make me cry or anything like that. So I just wanted to say that I have been lucky enough to meet so many passionate historians doing great work in towns across Connecticut, but I have never met anyone who is better at making the stories of our local past come alive to so many different kinds of people. Ed commands the attention of adults and children alike. When he talks, people want to listen. And being sort of somewhat of a pretend historian myself, I know how great and how hard that is to do. He has done more to show how local history is the real meat and potatoes of our shared national story than anyone I have ever known. And John Marr, John, you're probably in listening zone, you will be a person in here who will understand what I'm about to say. I have to fight a mostly losing battle when it comes to editing his written work. Oh, there's John. He's like, yeah, that's true. What Ed might not know is that the pleasure of these interactions will always be one of the highlights of my personal and professional life. And plus, he and Mary are really fun to travel with. And those stories, you have to come to see me separately. And bring me a drink. Thank you, Ed. And I have the pleasure of introducing our state representative, Roberta Willis. Roberta.
Thank you. It's obviously a pleasure to be here on this occasion. The thing that's amazing about Ed is we can talk about the historian, the geologist, the archaeologist, but he had some author. I found out that Sharon had a semi-pro baseball team, and he played on that. So he played semi-pro. He was a coach. One of his coachees went on to become a famous baseball player, winning a pennant for the Pittsburgh Pirates. And I'm sure that Ed's guidance certainly got him there. But the thing that's really amazing about Ed, and did I mention you were a veteran too, World War II? So there's so many things. Talk about lifetime achievement. Quite frankly, I don't know how the board is ever going to find somebody else in town to possibly ever get this award again. So maybe one time. But one of the things about Ed is because he has this wealth of knowledge, and he possesses this very commanding, authoritative voice. So we don't question anything he tells us. So when he tells us, as he did with me, that the reason we have rattlesnakes up on Easter Mountain is because there's Dalton quartzite and, you know, in the dens up there, and the rattlesnakes like the warmth. That, come on, Ed, did you go in the den? Did anybody ever go in to check if there's really Dalton quartzite? I don't think so. He knows what Mrs. Petit did on May 3rd, 1859, what Hiram Weed said to his workers in 1874. He has all this stuff, and you don't question it. You just accept that. But you know he's got us all when he has convinced us that the Sharon Valley Tavern is a historic landmark. He gives tours there.
Sign me up.
Yeah, exactly. Who knew? But I bring greetings and congratulations from the state of Connecticut as well. I don't want to forget Mary. Mary's here. And before I do the other awards, recognitions, I think the big recognition goes to the great woman behind. Half as much if it wasn't for Mary. This is a citation from the state of Connecticut, and hereby be it hereby known to all that the Connecticut General Assembly offers its sincerest congratulations to Ed M. Kirby in recognition of being the namesake of and the first honoree of the Edward M. Kirby Lifetime Achievement Award. You are an example for all. Your exemplary service and commitment. You are a man of many talents. You possess incredible knowledge on a wide range of subjects, and you continue to inspire intellectual curiosity. We thank you for your lifetime of commitment to education, to our history, and our heritage. We thank you for your devotion to the community, and you have enriched countless lives. A grateful community thanks you. And it's signed the 16th of November at the state capitol, and it's signed by the Speaker of the House and Secretary of the State of Connecticut. Congratulations, Ed. But Ed is really worthy of higher up on the food chain. So the governor sends greetings, and I try to read this without destroying it. By His Excellency Daniel P. Malloy, Governor, on behalf of the State of Connecticut, I, Daniel P. Malloy, Governor, take pleasure in congratulating Edward M. Kirby as you are honored with the Edward M. Kirby Lifetime Achievement Award by the Sharon Historical Society. This recognition is a testament to your outstanding service and commitment to the town of Sharon, the Historical Society and Museum, and to the state of Connecticut. As a successful educator, author, and public servant, you have clearly demonstrated your dedication to your profession and community. Generations to come will enjoy the story of the town of Sharon because of your diligence in preserving and recording the town's history. I congratulate you on this achievement and wish you continued success. Therefore, I, Daniel P. Malloy, Governor of the State of Connecticut, do hereby convey honor and recognition upon Edward M. Kirby in the State of Connecticut, and is signed by the Governor.
Thank you so much, Roberta. On behalf of the Sharon Historical Society and Museum, I'd like to present to you the Special Lifetime Achievement Award.
It doesn't come with the stand.
That's okay.
That's
what it is.
Thank you.
And also, we'd like to unveil the award itself. And this is a very special veil because last night at the event, I thought, what better way to award Ed Kirby his own award than have Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid come in? So this was the bag that it came in, which is actually my pillowcase. It fit the bill.
Just be careful.
Oh. And there is the award itself. Thank you. A book for all of you later on, if you like to sign, is in the front of the house. So we'd appreciate it if you could do that. Ed? I'd appreciate a few words from you.
Okay. I won't be too serious if you don't mind. This is really great. It's been a wonderful weekend. The top part of it was the having most of my family here. We had all five kids, and we had four of our seven grandchildren. So we had a lot of action around the house. The party didn't end when you think it did last night. Went out and well into the morning, but we're still around. I'd like to thank the Historical Society, especially Liz and Brent and Rosemary for the work that they do here and for helping me with this and making it a reality. It's really means a lot to me, and it means a lot when I see friends here like this that I see in different roles as I go around all these places. And most of all, I think any success I've had goes to Mrs. Kirby. I'd have to laugh because Roberta beat me on that one last night and tonight as well. And to give you an idea, I think everything I've done, she's really supported. And when she didn't support it, I knew darn well it wasn't going to work. So. I was smart enough for that, and I can remember one day I was playing first base for Sharon in the Interstate League, and I had three errors that day at first base, and I walked off the field at the end of the game, and somebody gave me one of these, you know, nice game, you know, and all that sort of stuff, and I said, I hope your wife didn't see this. I said, behind every great man is a great woman, and he said, I hope the hell she's wearing a first baseman's mitt. It's good to see. I don't want to rate the attendance here in any way, but the class of '66, my last class I was advisor for, has the most folks here, and I'd like to congratulate one of the areas that I work in, that McGee Allen, right back here. Wait, McGee, so they know where you are. And he came down with his, what do you call it? It's a lull, I know, but the big machine that he had. And we've just, we had taken the turbine that operated the blast furnace in East Canaan out of the shaft that was in. And we've been working a couple of years to get that restructured and taken care of. He came down and placed it very tenderly in its rack, and now if you go by there, the building is being built over it and painted. That's going to protect it. So that's been one of the big projects we've been working on this year. But we get so many volunteers like McGee that do so much, and we get the same thing here in Sharon, and I think that's really great. But my thanks to all of you, and I feel real good about this, and thanks very much for coming.
I'd like to say a few words from the town to the north, Salisbury. Starting in 1997, there have been three very, very successful bus tours where we've brought over 100 in each case, people around, gotten them off the bus and had talks. And of course, we now combine history and ecology, and that makes it a more interesting event. But before we do any of these, what do? We pick a date, we get on the phone to Ed. And we find out, Ed, does this work for you? And after we've got that date and we've got Ed on board, we know we're going to have a great trip. Because Ed knows a lot, it's fun to listen to, and the momentum is there. Our most recent one of about 3 weeks ago, we had 140 people on four buses. I think we had about 18 talks by about six speakers, but three of those talks were by Ed. Ed took care of geology, Ed took care of water power, Ed took care of iron in the furnace. And of course, he could have taken care of more, but he's willing to share. So Salisbury, Ed is not just a Sharon treasure, he's a regional treasure, and we in Salisbury thank him very much for helping to promote our history as well. Thank you.
You are a treasure to all. So, thank you very much, and thank you all for coming here to be here with us today. It was special. Thank you.